So in this video, we will be talking about how to get started with HDR videos. Now, just a disclaimer, what I'll be sharing with you today is what I've learned so far regarding HDR videography. If you don't know what HDR videos are, check out this great article from Airy explaining the main difference between SDR and HDR. In layman's terms though, HDR footage will have more colors and detail than SDR. Without being said, let's go ahead and get started. As of making this video, there are three main HDR flavors in the market right now. I say main because right now, HDR standards is pretty darn messy, so we'll be taking a look at three big ones. The first one is HDR10, which is the one I use. It's free. Pretty much majority of HDR videos right now are HDR10. I would say this is probably the closest to the standard right now. The second one is Dolby Vision. This version holds the highest quality of HDR content as of right now. Streaming services like Netflix and Amazon support this version. However, to use it, you will need to pay Dolby for a license fee. The third flavor we will talk about is HLG or Hybrid Log Gamma. This flavor is the only flavor between the three that is backwards compatible with SDR. That's why it's called hybrid. Now, the only issue I have with this flavor is that it doesn't give me enough HDR-esque quality to the footage. It's definitely my least favorite. Now that we talked about what types of HDRs there are, let's talk about how to shoot HDR content. Now, lucky for you, the camera you have right now is probably able to shoot HDR. With that being said, a camera that shoots RAW is definitely a plus. RAW cameras usually shoot at higher bits, which is good because 10-bit is a must when it comes to HDR shooting. RAW cameras, also like Blackmagic cameras and RED and Airy, usually have really good highlight and shadow recovery in post-production. That helps tremendously when you're pulling and pushing in post-production like DaVinci Resolve. At the end of the day, if your camera can shoot 10-bit and up, has a log profile, you should be able to create HDR videos. Here are some cameras below $5,000 that can shoot 10-bit and up. So now that you shot a footage that you want to turn into HDR, congratulations. What comes next is the poopy part. It is the roadblock that I ran into 2 years ago when I initially wanted to do HDR videos, hardware. More specifically, monitors. Back in 2018, the best workflow I came up with when I decided to dip into HDR was this. Edit my RAW footage in DaVinci Resolve without an HDR monitor, pretty much guessing what it will look like in HDR. Export it as an HDR footage, upload it as an HDR footage to YouTube, watch it on my HDR TV, take notes on what I need to change, make the changes, re-export, re-upload, watch it again, and the cycle continues. Probably the ugliest workflow ever. So you're probably asking yourself, why not just buy an HDR monitor back then? Well, at the time, there were only two real HDR monitors, the Sony BVM and the Dolby PRM. The Sony BVM cost $35,000 while the Dolby cost roughly around $40,000. So you kind of see why I gave up HDR for a little bit. But fast forward to 2020, we do have a little bit more options when it comes to HDR monitors. With that being said, here's what you have to keep in mind when shopping for an HDR reference monitor. Now, these are only recommendations, of course. They must have at least a 10-bit panel. Now, there are a lot of 10-bit panels out there that are not really 10-bit panels, so make sure when you're shopping for one to look up if it's an actual 10-bit and not 8 plus 2 FRC, although 8 plus 2 FRC would work as well if you absolutely can't get a 10-bit. 1,000 nits or more. Unless you want to master your HDR to something below 1,000 nits, then sure, buy a lower nit monitor. But if you want true HDR, 1,000 nits will save you in the long run. It's gonna look amazing. And lastly, get a monitor with the highest DCI P3 accuracy as much as possible. Color accuracy is as important as nit brightness. So now you have a camera, a monitor, what's next? Unfortunately for you, there is another essential piece of equipment you are going to need. And that is a capture or monitor card for your computer. If you absolutely want to view the best representation of what you are correcting in Resolve, you will need to dish out some cash on a capture or monitor card. I for one grabbed the Blackmagic DeckLink Mini 4K because it's cheap. Again, 2 years ago I was not able to do this because my motherboard was not supported. So before you even think about creating HDR videos, check the Blackmagic Design website to see what motherboards are compatible with the PCI Express capture cards or monitor cards they're selling. When I upgraded my computer last month, I made sure that my new motherboard is compatible with the DeckLink. Now that you have a reference monitor plugged into your computer via a DeckLink PCI Express card, all you have to do now is go to DaVinci Resolve, set your color space to 2020, and click Enable HDR via HDMI, and voila, your HDR monitor should kick in HDR mode. You can also calibrate your monitor using Resolve in a color meter, but I can do that on a separate video if you guys are interested. All right, guys, that is it for this video. The next part will be how to deal with footage in HDR in DaVinci Resolve from settings, importing, and exporting. If you do want to check out some HDR videos to test out your new iPhone 12, go ahead and check out my HDR playlist. And if you really want to see some really good HDR, probably the best on YouTube right now, check out Mystery Box's channel. These guys are actually the ones who really made me want to get into HDR videography about 2 years ago when I first ran into them. Like always, if you guys have any questions, let me know, and I will see you guys later.